my channel. Today's video is going to be my unpopular opinions school edition. This video right now is trending, and I already had this video planned out for me to record, but I decided to go ahead and do it a little bit early just to give you guys more content and just to put more videos out there. So this is what I'm going to be doing today. So without further ado, let's just go ahead and get started with this video. Coronavirus ruined the new school year. It ruined the new school year for everybody. And I really feel bad for the kids who are going to be freshmen in high school and for kids who is starting out in middle school as sixth graders. I feel bad for them because they don't know what to expect of their teachers. They don't know what the work is going to be like. They don't know how the teachers are going to act. None of that. And I actually went into, or I was actually going into my senior year with hope, with high hopes, like before they even came out with like the hybrid plan and the 100% virtual. I had high hopes for my senior year, and now I just kind of feel like it's just a regular grade, like it's 10th or 11th grade, because it really doesn't even feel like senior year. I mean, even though I just started out, but it doesn't even feel like senior year. Like, I was excited about my senior year at first, but now I'm not as excited as I was like in June. In June, I was really, 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 really excited about my senior year, but I'm not that excited anymore. I mean, maybe when it comes to graduation or when I turn 18, then I'll get excited then. But right now, I'm not really excited because it's my senior year and I'm like half in school and I'm like half at home. So senior year for me, I guess, is kind of already ruined. Number two, school lunch or school food in general is nasty. It's nasty. Now, I don't eat school food anymore. I used to eat it when I was in elementary school. But then I used to have allergies. And that's when I stopped eating school food. I think it was in third grade too when I stopped eating it. Maybe beforehand, I don't really know. But I remember I've been taking my lunch to school since elementary, and I'm a senior in high school and I'm still bringing my lunch to school because I used to be allergic to eggs, cheese, and milk, and I really didn't know like what the people were putting in the food. So when I started getting my allergies, I had to stop eating it and I had to start bringing my own food. But when I was eating it, it was nasty. They don't give us the good food. They don't give us the good food at all. And when I was in middle school, the food there just looked nasty. Like they had the food on these little white trays, and they had like the little the smiley face fries and everything. Now those used to be good. I ate those when I was in elementary school. And then when I got to high school, the food started to look worse. Even though I didn't eat it, but it looked worse. It looked worse than the middle school food and the elementary school food combined. Maybe it was just my school, I don't really know. But when I was eating school food, it was nasty. It was really nasty. Number three, Zoom is overrated. It really is. I mean, personally, I don't join any of these Zoom calls. And honestly, there's no point in me really joining them unless I'm confused. But who is out here really joining these Zoom calls? Like, if you're not 100% virtual, who is out here joining these Zoom calls? Because I'm not. I'm actually in the hybrid plan. I'm with the hybrid kids. So there's really no point in me even joining a Zoom call unless I'm confused. But Zoom is overrated. Like, all these teachers out here, they really want us to join these Zoom calls, whether we're 100% virtual or not. But if I'm not confused or if I don't have any questions about anything, then I'm not gonna join a Zoom call. Number four, the hybrid plan is better than the 100% virtual plan. The only reason why I'm saying this is because, okay, a lot of people don't know what hybrid is. So hybrid is when you go to school for like 2 days out of the week, and then the other 3 days you're at home. So I go to school in person on Mondays and Wednesdays, and then I'm at home on Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays. But hybrid is better than 100% virtual because when you go to school, you get instructions on what to do when you're at home. And I just kind of feel like it's better because obviously the 100% virtual kids don't go to school. They don't see their teachers in person. And the only reason why I chose hybrid was because it's my senior year. It's going to be my last year in my high school. And personally, I learn better in person. Like, when I see the teacher in person explaining it, depending on what it is, I just learn better in person. So that was really why I chose the hybrid plan. But hybrid is definitely better than 100% virtual. Number five, sick kids need to stay in the house. You need to stay at the house. If you wake up thinking that you're gonna throw up, or you're coughing really bad, you sneezing every 5 seconds, you got a headache and you have body aches, stay at the house. Stay at the house. Do not bring your coronavirus to school, because we don't want it. We don't want it. We already out here risking our lives, putting our lives and our family lives in danger by coming out here to school trying to learn. So if you think you, when you wake up and you think you don't feel good, stay at the house, because we do not want your coronavirus. We don't want it. Number six, teachers need to lighten up with the work. Now, I already know it's the beginning of the school year. School literally just started for me 5 days ago, and these teachers are already piling work on us. They already piling the work. And I've only been in school technically for 5 days, because I've been at home for 3 of those days. But they already piling up with the work. Like, we just started 5 days ago. Why you piling up with all this work? Like, we just started. Give us a little bit of a break. Like, we just started. And I get that they're trying to prepare us, like the seniors anyway, they're trying to prepare us for college and for the real world and for like other grades. They're trying to prepare them for the next year. But just lighten up with the work. Like, we don't need all the work. Like, 4 or 5 different worksheets at one time? No, ma'am, that's too much. Because I remember last year when I was a junior, my English teacher gave us like 3 or 4 assignments at one time. And she would be like, okay, y'all have these assignments to do. Y'all need to get them done because they're due on Friday. And she would give them to us like on a Tuesday or something. And most of the times, we really wouldn't even be able to work on it in class because she would be giving us another assignment. I mean, it was just the worst. Like, last year, if you're going into your junior year, just know there's going to be a lot of work. It's going to be a lot of work, because when I was a junior, I had so much work, especially in English, chemistry, and algebra 2. Those three right there, those were my worst subjects last year. But teachers really need to lighten up with the work, especially because of coronavirus. Even though we are, like, if you did choose the hybrid plan, you are going to school. But if you chose 100% virtual, they really don't need to be giving us all this work, because honestly, it's already too much. It's already too much. Number seven, masks should be mandatory. Every school should be doing this. My school is doing this. But on Wednesday, it was 1 or 2 people in my school who was not wearing a mask. And I was like, if you're not gonna wear a mask, what's the point of coming to school? Because we're supposed to wear a mask to protect ourselves from these other people, because we don't know if they have the virus or not. So if you don't have a mask, then don't come to school. Just stay at home or go 100% virtual. Because again, we do not want your coronavirus. We don't. We really don't. So please wear your masks if you go to school or anywhere else out in public. Number 8, online work is easy. Now, I'm only saying it's easy for me because I'm doing the hybrid plan. I go to school on Mondays and Wednesdays. And so when I'm at home on Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays, I already know what I'm doing. So whatever work the teacher gives us, I have like examples or notes from the days that I was in school. So personally, I think online work is really easy. Number 9. Zoom should be mandatory for the 100% virtual kids. It should be mandatory for them because obviously they don't go to school at all. They're at home for the whole entire week. But I already know a few of my teachers said that we need to join a Zoom call. I understand if we're like at home and they want us to join in, but if I really don't have any questions or if I'm not confused about anything, then I'm not really going to join a Zoom call. But if I am, then I will, or I'll just email them. But it's not mandatory for the hybrid kids to join in on a Zoom call. I don't know why teachers are saying that, but it's not mandatory for us. We didn't choose to be at home 100%. So Zoom should be mandatory for the virtual kids. Number 10, sharing should not be allowed. So obviously because of coronavirus, we can't share anything. We can't share supplies or anything like that. The teachers are not allowed to hand us papers. We're not allowed to hand them anything. But some kids are doing it. They're putting themselves at risk. I'm not doing it. Because that's like when you guys saw my art supply haul. I bought all of those things for my art class because we're not supposed to be sharing stuff. But I'm actually have to find like a case or something to put all that stuff in so I can take it to school. But we're not supposed to be sharing anything, and kids are already sharing stuff. So that's them doing their thing. I'm not doing it because I'm not trying to catch coronavirus. So if they want to share, go for it. I'm not doing it. Number 11. Kids should not bring all of their supplies to school on the first day. Now, I'm not gonna lie, I used to do this. I did this in elementary school and probably on up until middle school, maybe like 7th grade. I was bringing my supplies, all my supplies that I bought on the first day. It's not necessary. We don't even use all of the supplies on the first day. The only thing you probably use is a pencil and some paper, or put paper in the binder and write on the paper from there. Because on the first day before coronavirus, teachers would give us like their syllabus and what to expect in their class, and like these different papers for our parents to sign. That's really all they did, but now they don't do that obviously because of coronavirus. But there's no point in bringing all of your school supplies on the first day because you don't need it. It just puts more weight on you, lows down your backpack. That's how your backpack can easily tear up. So do not bring all your supplies on the first day. Number 12. This here is probably really far-fetched, but I feel like seniors should be able to do whatever we want, especially for me, because you guys know I love to take a lot of pictures and videos. So I feel like we should be able to do whatever we want because it's our last year there. We won't be there again unless we come back and visit teachers. But I kind of feel like we should do whatever we want because it's our last year. And I just like to take pictures and videos because there's like this big window part of my school that connects two buildings upstairs. And during a certain time of the day, when the sun is out, I just like to go up there and take pictures. I don't know if I'll be able to do that this year because I did do that last year when I was a junior. But I really hope I can do it this year. That's why I'm praying for sunshine on all Mondays and Wednesdays so I can dress cute and try to take some pictures and videos. But I just kind of feel like seniors should be allowed to do whatever we want because it's our last year there. And we won't be going back. And I'm actually really sad that, I'm not actually sad I'm graduating, but this is my last year my school, and I'm really gonna miss it. I mean, I really love my school. Some of the grown-ups there, they're pretty nice. Some of the other ones are kind of mean. But I'm really gonna miss my high school. I'm really gonna miss it. Number 13, Zoom should be canceled. It should be canceled because who is really out here joining these Zoom calls? I mean, everywhere you hear it, every state, all you hear is Zoom, 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 Zoom. That's all you hear, Zoom, Zoom, Zoom. Like, who's joining these Zoom calls? Like, other than students, who's really joining these Zoom calls? Who's really joining them? Because I'm not joining these Zoom calls. Like, I'm not joining them at all unless I need help. But everybody out there is just putting out Zoom, Zoom for this, Zoom for that, Zoom, Zoom, Zoom. And some of my teachers already have like Zoom links set up and everything, and they weren't even the right links for the right class period. Like, if you're gonna set it up the correct way, because I just wanted to join in one of my meetings or in one of my classes just to be nosy. And it wasn't even my class period. It was like first period or third period or something. And it wasn't even second period. So I was just joining in to be nosy, but it wasn't even my class period. But Zoom should be canceled. It should be canceled and thrown in the trash, okay? Number 14, teachers should be more lenient and understanding. And what I mean by this is, if we can't turn in all of our work on time like it's supposed to, because everybody now is online, they're doing like all these online classes, and so a lot of websites, they be crashing. Like, when you try to turn something in, the screen just freezes or it takes a really, really long time to upload. So I feel like teachers should be more lenient and be more understanding that stuff is going to crash. Stuff is not always going to work 100%. But I feel like they should be more lenient. And last but not least, number 15, different websites for work is unnecessary. It's unnecessary. Some online courses that I already have, I have like Edgenuity, Clever, Curve, and I think there's one more. I'm trying to think of it. I think there's one more. I don't really know. Google Classroom, that's another one. That's the other one. All these different websites for classes and courses and work and tests and stuff, that's not needed. Just put all your stuff on one website for everybody in the whole entire school, and just let that one website be your one resource, because going to all these different websites is not it, because some of these websites, they be crashing, some be working just fine, some be loading slow, some be loading really, really fast, but all these different websites, it's not necessary. It's really not. And because I remember I was working on Edgenuity, my sophomore year, and I did not like it. And now we already have an Edgenuity assignment. Like, I have an Edgenuity, Google Classroom, and I even think like a Curve assignment, but I already did two of them, so I'm fine, I'm good to go. But the Edgenuity, mainly that one, I don't know if y'all know about that one, but my school system uses Edgenuity, but it's not it. I don't like it. So they need to pick one website and stick to that website for all of our work and tests and stuff to be turned into, because it's just too much. It's too much already. It's just too much. But those are all of my unpopular opinions. I'm going to be showing you guys my senior pictures. It's just a little bonus clip, but I'm gonna be showing you guys my senior pictures. So I did take my senior pictures last Saturday, and they actually said I could pick them up in an hour from when I took them, but we had other stuff to do that day, so they told me to come back in a week. And I got them back, and they are all really, really pretty. And I did tell you guys I was going to show you what they look like. So this is the first page. This right here are my casual pictures. I chose my own outfit I wanted to wear. So these pictures here came out really, really pretty. And I think my favorite one out of the bunch, I think it would have to be this one right here. This one right here is definitely my favorite. But all of these are really pretty. This one is full body. This one is technically full body, and then these two are more up close. But this is the first set of my pictures. And then this is the second set of my pictures. We're not gonna be getting these two right here because my bra strap was showing. Like right there, my bra strap was showing. And I'm kind of sad about that because these pictures, like these two pictures right here, came out really, really pretty. But we're going to be keeping this book, so I'll be able to see these pictures all the time. But we're not going to get them printed out in like big pictures because my bra strap was showing. And I really don't want a picture of my bra strap showing in a bigger picture. But yeah, and then this down here is where like the Drake picture started. I wish they would have put it all on the same page, but that's okay. And then this picture right here, I don't really know how I feel about it. I mean, it came out pretty, but I don't know if it's one of my favorites. So now on to the next page. I think this set of pictures right here, I think these might be my favorite. These are all of the Drake's. I would have to say this is my favorite set. I think my favorite picture out of the bunch is probably this one down here or this one at the top. But I think all of these pretty much came out pretty. I guess all of these are my favorite because I really can't tell, but I really think I like this one better. But they all kind of look the same, just a little bit, but they all came out really, really pretty. And then the last set of pictures that I have is me in the cap and the gown. I like these pictures up here better than these. But my favorite one is definitely this one right here. These came out pretty too, but these are not really one of my favorites. But all my pictures came out pretty. And I'll probably put my favorite pictures like up close on the screen somewhere, like throughout this segment. But yeah, so those are my senior pictures. For watching this video, I really hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to comment, like, subscribe, and share my channel, and help me reach my new goal of 750 subscribers. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.